Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Skeeter Rabbit Road to the Show series here in MLB 15 the Show on the PS4. When we left off, Skeeter Rabbit had just made his debut in Double-A ball when this happened. He got one hit, he got on base, and he tore his Achilles tendon. He had to be carried off the field, and the news was bad. It was torn, and he'd be headed to the 60-day disabled list. So now we just have to let this play out and see when the next time that Skeeter Rabbit will actually be on the field. Will it be this year? Will he get back to be able to play here? I'm guessing probably not with a torn Achilles tendon, but we're just going to have to play this forward and see. Time in the DL is up. However, you're still severely injured. Yeah, and you remain on the 60-day DL. So here we go. We're continuing to be out of the lineup with this significant injury. And we stop here for a second because we have a trade within the organization. Nothing major going on here that affects Skeeter Rabbit. Let's keep going. And let's see. We're getting through the month of July. Oh, here's a big trade. Alex Gordon for Alex Cobb. Straight up. Okay. Big trade there between the Royals and Rays. Huh. All right. So the Rays acquire another outfielder. I don't know how Skeeter Rabbit feels about that, but doesn't have a whole lot of choice. Oh, my goodness. Here's directly one that affects him. Center fielder Mookie Betts coming to the Rays for Jake McGee. Direct competition at the major league level there now. And a youngster in Mookie Betts. Ew. Well, okay. Well, Skeeter Rabbit's on the shelf. The Rays are stocking up. Now we got another big trade. Evan Gattis, Gonzalez, and Gregerson for Alex Gordon. So Alex Gordon was traded one for one, and now they get three pieces for one in a trade. They go ahead and deal them again. So the Rays busy here. Again, the 60-day DL runs out, but he's still injured. Yeah, he's not getting back this year. I don't see it happening, which is really just so hard to believe. He had one at-bat this entire season before he had this happen to him. So the Montgomery Biscuits qualify for the postseason here. They'll be taking on the Smokies. And the Smokies beat them. So there you go. The Biscuits are out of the Double-A playoffs. So the season is now over. It's a lost season for Skeeter Rabbit. Just one at bat. And there you go. In Major League Baseball, the Pirates defeat the Tigers in the 2015 World Series. Well, that's one way to get through a season. A season-ending injury right off the bat. You see Suzuki is named to the Hall of Fame. He's inducted right here. Apparently just by his lonesome. So they go ahead and do that. So here we go. Well, we've been out rehabbing all this time. We're going to renegotiate a salary for the second season. I don't know. Is this going to be prorated here? If we play just one game again, do we get paid like $500 or what's going to go on here? So they reject my offer that I put up a little bit. They counter. We'll go ahead and take that since, yeah, you know, we don't have much that we've proven ourselves by yet. And frankly, they don't have to really do much for us at this point because we're not like going to be a free agent or anything like that for a long time. So here we go as we are kicking into what will be his season debut. It won't be his Double-A debut because, well, he played one game or had one at bat or whatever. And how about his first at bat this year? Okay. So he lines that one to the gap in right. This is going to be him not stopping. He'll go straight to third base. He's got a triple. So he starts the year off with a triple. Everybody holds their breath. Okay. That's kind of funny. That's not his first career Double-A hit. That happened last year in his one at bat. So that's wrong, but anyway, you got runners on first and second, nobody out. He's going to put down a sacrifice bunt right there, giving himself up to move the runners over. Very nice job, and that's part of his offensive skill set right there, setting the table for others. Now in the fourth inning with a 3-0 lead, he hits this one hard to center field. He had a sack bunt. Now he's got a sack fly, as this will get a run home from third base on the tag up. But now another guy, okay, he came all the way from around from second and tried to score. That was quite foolish. I don't know why he's doing that. But regardless, Skeeter Rabbit finding ways to help his team one way or another. This fly ball in center field, he's got to fight the sun a little bit there. as he does make the catch. So nice job out in center field. And all in all, hey, it's a great debut. You know why? Because he stayed healthy first and foremost. He didn't tear anything. He didn't get carried off the field. And he made a contribution. So nice job starting off the 2016 season. Now let's see if he can keep things going here as we'll go into game number two. Ooh, big relief to not be injured. First inning at bat, and he is going to line that one to left center. It is down for a hit, so he's got a single, and he's on with that speed. Let's see if he's interested in stealing a base. Here he goes, taking off on the 3-2 count. That ball is lined into center field, and he's not stopping, going to third easily, first to third with that speed. And now the Biscuits are in business. Base is loaded, nobody out. This is a fly ball. Rabbit looking to tag up. Oh, it's really hanging up there. And honestly, I think I left early right there, but they're not going to penalize me for it. Tags up and scores. I felt like I left a count early right there. But I guess not. I guess we're good. Okay, next at bat in the second inning, up 4-0 right now, and base hit off the mound and up the middle of the diamond and into center field. On again is Skeeter Rabbit. He's got a runner in front of him this time, so he won't be trying to steal a base unless that becomes open. Now he's up in the eighth, up 7-1, and he's got his third hit of the night. Makes him 3-for-5, I believe. Runner will stay at third, but there you go, a three-hit game for Skeeter Rabbit. This time there's a base open that he could try to steal, and he's going to do just that. He's in there safe ahead of the throw, even though it was just an okay jump. Using that speed, and the Biscuits win 7-3. All right, haven't lost yet on this early season, 2-0. And that three-hit game for Skeeter Rabbit makes for one happy manager. Now you got this is a five-game series. You play long series here in double-A ball. So we're going to continue to hopefully pound on the Mississippi Braves. Game number three of this series about to start. First inning, Skeeter Rabbit. Oh, that's in the gap in right center. I feel like the second baseman might have been able to make a play on that if he stuck his glove up or tried to make a leaping grab or something, but he didn't really make much of an effort, and that goes for a triple for Skeeter Rabbit. I think you're going to see him doing this quite often here, ending up on third base with a triple. Now he's going to score on the ground out. So that's the problem you face here with his speed. If you can hit the ball in the alley, you're going to end up giving up a run quite easily. This one, he waited on the hanging breaking ball, and he lost this one into the gap all the way to the fence. Like I said, he's going to end up on third a lot. He's got another triple. Oh, he thought about maybe going to the plate on that play. Good idea to stop at third. So two triples in this game. Just a 1-0 game here. This ball hit deep where, well, not, yeah, sort of deep. He's going to give it a try, and it will not be cut off, and it will not get him out either. So he tags up and scores once again, putting lots of pressure by getting on third base. Here he's got to track this one right center field, and he will make the catch. So a nice job out in center yet again. 4-0 in the fourth. Runners at the corners. This will be smoked to center field. It will be caught. But that will be another easy sacrifice fly, so he gets an RBI out of this situation, making the most of his outs. It's a very early look in this season so far, but so far this guy is looking very impressive on what he can bring to the ball club. That's going to be another hit up the middle, and he's on first. Well, at least they kept him from hitting a triple. I guess that's a win in this situation. He is going to try to take second, however. Ball gets away from the catcher. Had Skeeter Rabbit seen it and not slid head first, he might have been able to take third on that play, but he'll go ahead and be satisfied with a steal right there. Another breaking pitch that stays up, and he hits that hard, and you see the center fielder cuts it off, but his momentum going towards the outfield there. Skeeter Rabbit picks up on that little clue and keeps going to second base because he knows he can make it in there. As the throw would not be strong enough to get him, the Biscuits win 7-3. They've won all three games in this series so far. Keep it rolling, guys. Keep it rolling. And it's in no small part from Skeeter Rabbit's contributions here. So he's got 8 hits and 11 at-bats. He is smoking hot right now. So we go to game 4 of this series. And he's going to get a little spotlight here for his 4-hit game. First ever for that. So he's had a three-hit game, a four-hit game. What is he going to follow all that up with today? Let's see. First inning, two runners on, and he's going to smoke that one to right field. It's down for a hit. Runner coming around third and will try to score. He will do just that. Runners at the corners, but Skeeter Abbott picks up an RBI on the play as well. I believe that's his third RBI of the season. 3-3 in the third inning. Skeeter Abbott up again. Going opposite field here with some power into the alley. That'll be off the wall. He's got two. He's not stopping there, though. He's going for three. And he will not be denied a triple on this play. Like I said, you're going to see a lot of these this year. A lot of triples. If he can continue to hit the ball into the gaps with the effectiveness he's done so far here. 4-3 in the fifth inning. And that's going to scoot through the right side for a hit. So he's on again. Okay. Skeeter Rabbit is a tough, tough out at the moment. And, the Braves are just not figuring him out. Sixth inning, this pitch is up, and it's hit well the opposite field. Come on now, get out of here. It's gone. First homer.
What another nickel in the merry-go-round. This one is getting ugly. And, Steve, what a nice moment that is for him, his first home run as a Double-A player.
Yeah, and you always like to get those firsts out of the way, but the first home run, well, that's kind of extra special for any hitter. This is exactly the kind of production that this team's going to be looking for from him as he moves up through the minor leagues.
Skeeter Rabbit hits his first Double-A homer, and he is now just a double short of hitting for the cycle in this ball game. He's got four hits, takes that one over the wall and into the bullpen, and he's got another chance to do this in the ninth inning. Can he come up with a double? Well, it's up the middle. It's a base hit. Runner is going to try for third. Skeeter Rabbit going for second. He is in at second, but I don't think they're going to credit him with a double. They say base hit, and he advances on the throw. So, no, he does not get the cycle, but he's got a five-hit game and a 13-3 win. The Biscuits and Skeeter Rabbit are red hot, as you see some milestone there, first Double-A home run, and a five-game hitting streak to boot, as we did sim forward one game as well. They swept that series, all five games. Skeeter Rabbit is hot. He's not injured. He's ready to go in Double-A here. Let's get him going towards that Triple-A promotion. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!